let's learn about carbon dioxide transport in the blood. Our lungs exchange oxygen and carbon dioxide. Our cells take in oxygen and use it for making energy to keep us alive. The cells also produce carbon dioxide that must be carried to the lungs by way of the blood. Carbon dioxide diffuses into the blood. A small amount of carbon dioxide is carried in the blood plasma. A little more is carried in the red blood cell by hemoglobin. Carbon dioxide diffuses into the red blood cell where it can attach to hemoglobin, forming carbaminohemoglobin. Most of the carbon dioxide is carried in the bicarbonate ion. Here's how it works. Carbon dioxide diffuses into the red blood cell. Once inside, it combines with water and an enzyme called carbonic anhydrase to form carbonic acid. Since the carbonic acid is ionically bonded, it dissociates into hydrogen ions and bicarbonate ions. The bicarbonate ion moves out of the red blood cell through a protein channel. The hydrogen ion binds to hemoglobin, triggering the Bohr effect. The bicarbonate ion channel also co-transports chloride into the red blood cell. This is called the chloride shift. Since this reaction also occurs in the blood, but without carbonic anhydrase, a buildup of carbon dioxide in the blood can have an effect on blood pH because of the production of hydrogen ions. If the respiratory system cannot get rid of carbon dioxide, more hydrogen ions are produced, causing the pH to go down. The blood can become acidic in a condition known as respiratory acidosis. You can induce a slight state of respiratory acidosis by holding your breath. Likewise, if too much carbon dioxide leaves the lungs, the hydrogen ion concentration decreases in the blood, causing it to become alkaline. This condition is called respiratory alkalosis. You can induce a state of respiratory alkalosis by hyperventilating. We hope you have learned something about carbon dioxide transport, and see you next time.